Hi, y'all. All right, let's talk today about vector synthesis. I see vector synthesis appear in a bunch of online lists of common types of synthesis, but I actually rarely teach vector synthesis myself because rather than a distinct type of synthesis, I tend to think of vector synthesis as just a means of control. Today, let me talk through it just a little bit, and then we'll build our own simple vector synthesizer and reactor that gives you something to expand on. And you can decide for yourself whether you think this is a distinct form of synthesis or not. The term vector synthesis was coined by Sequential Circuits in their Prophet VS synthesizer. The basic idea here is we have a vector plane. We have two axes. I think originally in the Prophet synth, they called it the AB axis and the CD axis. I'm going to talk about it today as an XY axis. But our idea here is we have this plane, this two-dimensional plane. We can move our joystick or cursor in this plane in real time to change our sound parameters. In the Prophet VS, they had digital wavetable oscillators that were sort of at all of the four corners of this plane using these XY controls on a joystick. Later examples of vector synthesis use FM, adjusting different properties of the modulators, and you can also do this with filtering. What I'm going to do today in Reaktor is I'm just going to put something together that has a different waveform in each corner of a square and show an example of how we can use vector synthesis for real-time timbral control. In my new ensemble here, let's delete our inputs. The main part of this is going to be panel, this XY. We can see on the panel, this gives us a two-dimensional plane that we can move a cursor between. And if we look carefully, we can see that there's an X value and a Y value. Okay, X is our horizontal, 0 to the left, 1 to the right. Y is our vertical, 0 down, 1 up. Okay? You can notice that this has inputs and outputs. You can also use this as a kind of scope, but we're not going to use these inputs at all because we're going to use this as a control. Now, I haven't decided whether I'm going to get to it today or not, but you can also just map this control to a MIDI controller or to what I often do, touch OSC on your phone or another OSC controller. Once again, maybe we'll do that if we have time. So let's start by just having a sawtooth wave oscillator, just a simple one. Let's create our controls. Today, for simplicity's sake, let's use an AR envelope to run our gate into, and I'm not going to create in controls. Once again, as you make your synth more sophisticated, you know how to create more interesting envelopes. And if you don't, I'll throw a link up top here just for you to check it out. All right, let's ignore the XY. Just run this to the outs. All right, there's my usual do, re, mi, fa, sol that I like to do. An octave lower. Okay, so far so good. Now, what I can do is I can take this and multiply it. What if I were to multiply this by just the X? Okay, think for a second about what's going to happen. When my X is all the way to this side, or rather when my cursor is all the way to this side, my X is 0. So all the way to this side, it's 1. So here we go. Let me play my do, re, mi, fa, sol. Okay. Now Y isn't doing anything here, right? Why? Because it's only about the X. Okay. Let's do a pulse oscillator. Now, of course, we could do more interesting things like map to the pulse width, but we'll just do the very simplest example here. Okay. So if I took this pulse wave and multiplied it by X, oh, we've got another problem here too, right? Create a mixer, put the sawtooth on the top, the pulse at the bottom, and then let me just create a constant for the level. Let's do -6 decibels for the moment. The reason I'm doing a constant is I don't want to have individual controls because these are my volume controls, but I need this combiner to combine them together. I could just do an add, but this is allowing me to do some attenuation. So let's check this out. So, as our X moves up, the sawtooth volume gets greater, and then the pulse volume also gets greater. So if I wanted the pulse to get quieter as that moved up instead, I could do this. Let's put in a subtract. Create constant. 1 minus X. All right, let's think about that. When X is 1, 1 minus 1 is going to be 0. When X is 0, 1 minus 0 is going to be 1. So we've effectively inverted that. Okay, so now when we're over on this side, we should hear our pulse. Pulse, saw, pulse, saw. Hey, pretty neat. So, well, this is one dimensional, right? It doesn't care about the Y. But here's the start of my vector synthesizer. Okay, just to be a bit neater here, I'm gonna Command X, new macro, vector oscillator. Go inside, paste it, output. Output. So adding our Y in here is going to get a bit more complicated, but we're ready. We get this general idea that when we're close to a point, we want it to be 1, right? Multiplying it by 1. And as we get further away, whether it's going further away this way, or further away this way, or further away this way, we want it to get closer and closer to 0 as it gets away from that point. Now, there are probably ways to do this with figuring out hypotenuses and things like that, but we'll keep it a little bit simpler today. And you can explore these in more detail moving forward. But let me do this. Triangle oscillator and a sine oscillator. This might not necessarily be the most interesting choice of all my waveforms. And so maybe if I have a moment at the end here, I'll make this a bit more interesting. But for now, let's just wire these up. Again, we can move our wires, we can see everything, make sure everything's plugged into the right place. So one thing that I could consider is I could just take this, duplicate it, run this here, here, make sure all of our levels are at minus 6 dB, and then triangle. I know this is a mess of wires. Again, we're always wiggling to make sure that's looking good. Sine is going to there, triangle is going to there, pulse is going to there. It shouldn't go to both of those. Let me get rid of that. There we go. Pulse is going to there, triangle to there is good, sine to there is good, sawtooth to there is good. Okay. And then we could just wire up our Y to here, and our Y to here. Now, we haven't quite accomplished what we're doing, but let's listen to this. Okay, it's a start, but when we're in this corner, for example, this is now, since X is 0, that means we have full volume of pulse. And since Y is 0, we also have full volume of sine, but it's the pulse mixed with the sine, so that's not really what we want. We want each corner to be its own thing, right? Similarly, if I go here, again, X is 0, so it's still full pulse, but also Y is 1, so that means full triangle. Here, X is 1, so that's full saw, full triangle. And then here is full saw, full sine. And of course, that sine's gonna get totally lost in this sawtooth wave. I mean, we hear this X difference a lot. We don't hear the Y difference a whole lot. So let's think about sending these to each individual corner. So in that case, when X is 0 and Y is 1, let's have this just be our sine wave. I'm going to do something similar, but let me build it from scratch just to make it more clear. I should probably build from the top. So let's start with our sawtooth. Let's make one be sawtooth. Okay. So in that case, we'll take our multiply. We want X to be 1 and Y to be 1 for our sawtooth wave, right? So when X is 1, we want it to be full, and then it will fade out as we go that way. And then let's take another multiply for our X dimension, or rather for our Y dimension. And so now when Y is 1, that'll be full volume, okay? Does that make sense? Full volume, and as we get away from 1, it gets quieter. Sorry, that's our X there. So we get away from 1, it gets quieter. And as we get away this way, it gets quieter. All right. Let's think about our pulse. Let's put our pulse here. Okay, so now we have a different set of rules. Still, when X is 1, we want it to be loud. But here, on our Y, right, remember this is our Y, we want to flip it. Here's where we put in our subtract. So now, just very carefully, what we're subtracting here, create constant, give us our 1. What we're subtracting here is the Y. Okay, let's check this out now. Square, nothing. We haven't assigned these corners yet. Saw. Okay, let's keep going. And now we know, I'm actually just gonna duplicate this and move it over. Now for both of these, we know we want them to kick in when X is 0. So I wanna have this, and also, this is always what I get for trying to keep everything on the screen at the same time. Might give us a bit more space here. So both of those are gonna be now multiplying by 1 when our X is 0. And I can then just take this, Command-D, move this down, this. Just checking my wires here, yes. I apologize for all the crossing, but there's not really much one can do in this situation. Let's try it. I've made a mistake somewhere. We'll fix it in a second. Zero, zero. That sounds like our triangle wave. Zero, zero. That should be our sine wave, rather. This should be my triangle wave. So I've made a mistake here. Ah, there we go. This one needs to be X. This one needs to be X. Again, super hard to see this, but let's make sure those wires... Okay, the X's are all going... Actually, that's maybe a better way to orient it, right? Now we can see all of our X's are going to this first operation, all of our Y's... There's a missing wire there, right? This one needs to go in... Oh, no, it's there, it's just that angle, we can't see it. There we go. Okay, try again. Triangle. Sine, square, saw. Behold my vector synthesizer. Okay. You know, we can just add a ladder filter here. I believe in the Prophet VS, there was just a filter. Probably not a ladder filter, but there was just a filter on these waveforms. Again, the Prophet VS, I believe, had digital waveforms, but it had far more interesting, sophisticated waveforms than I have. And we can beef those up a little bit, but here we go. Filtering the sine wave doesn't matter. Don't filter sine waves, remember. So now as I play keys, right? I can control that in real time. Once again, it's a bit boring to do this with the mouse. I'd probably map this to OSC, but you know, maybe I'll hold off on that today. What might be a more interesting way to close here is, and maybe I'll fast motion some of this, but maybe I can make a more interesting set of oscillators here. Let me tinker with that for just one moment. Okay, let's hear how I did. Just to quickly talk through, I made this two detuned sawtooth waves up in 1-1 here. I changed the duty cycle of this pulse wave to make it a bit more interesting. I ring modulated this triangle wave, and then I just got rid of the sine wave altogether and made it a pulse mixed with a sawtooth, a sawtooth mixed with a pulse an octave down. See how we did. Make it so I can play some chords. Audio voice combiner. Voices 4. All right. Upper right, lower right, upper left, lower left. Of course, you could map your filter to be this. Just move the cutoff up and down as you go. And as I mentioned, FM synthesis, think about changing your modulation index as you move this around. Tons to do. Again, there are way more interesting ways to control your synth than with just the keyboard. Keep in mind, you can make this absolutely gigantic if you want. Go to view, and okay, we'll make it 300 pixels by 300 pixels. Whoops, not 30, by 300 pixels. Get my filter knobs out of the way. And then, whoops. More detailed control. Map this to your Touch OSC or your other controllers. And now you have a new way to explore timbres as you perform. Great for drone music, great for changing textures. All right, I'm gonna leave it there for today. Play with this, mess around with it, change the things. Let me know what you come up with.